The engineering team responsible for this two-stroke engine deserves recognition. According to online documentation, this single-cylinder semi-diesel marine engine resumed operation after 2 decades in a scrapyard. Attention Ferrari and Formula One enthusiasts. Join us in experiencing the Ferrari 8, a tribute to the legendary 1964 and 1965 racing seasons, whose V8 engine continues to captivate motorsport aficionados. The Ash 62 represents a milestone in transport and civil aviation engineering. This Soviet-engineered power plant, derived from the American W1820 Cyclone, made its debut in 1938. The Ash 62 continues its service today, particularly in Antonov aircraft. The AVRO 504 emerged as a significant First World War biplane aircraft, manufactured by the AVRO Aircraft Company and various licensed producers. Its wartime production reached an impressive 8,970 units, with manufacturing continuing for nearly 2 decades. This made it the most extensively produced military aircraft of any type during the First World War, with total production exceeding 10,000 units between 1913 and 1940. Attendees at the Danish Timewinder Festival were left with a lasting impression by the Rolls-Royce GRIFFON engine. This was not just due to the engine's rich acoustics, but also to its raw force, which, at 2,500 revolutions per minute, generated gusts that were powerful enough to blow away hats. The WRIGHT R3350 DUPLEX-CYCLONE represents an American engineering achievement as a twin-row, supercharged, air-cooled radial aircraft engine featuring 18 cylinders and a displacement of approximately 54.9 liters. Power output varied from 2,200 to 3,700 horsepower, depending on model. The engine underwent extensive development prior to World War II, with its design requiring significant time to reach maturity. During its early deployment in the Boeing B-29 Superfortress, reliability issues persisted. However, post-war refinements led to its successful implementation in numerous civilian aircraft, particularly in its advanced turbo-compound configurations. Denmark houses the DEUTZ MK260, the largest horizontal diesel engine of its kind, featuring a 67 liters displacement and boasting 94 years of operational history. Following comprehensive restoration, it maintains smooth operation and impressive acoustics. The Jacobs R-755 represents a seven-cylinder, air-cooled, radial aircraft engine manufactured in the United States by the Jacobs Aircraft Engine Company. Initial operation of the R-755 commenced in 1933, with production continuing into the 1970s. The engine featured specifications including a 133mm by 127mm bore and stroke, yielding a displacement of 12.4 liters. Power output ranged from 200 horsepower to 350 horsepower. Construction incorporated steel cylinders paired with aluminum alloy cylinder heads. A specialized R-755E variant was later engineered specifically for helicopter applications. This diesel two-stroke V12, previously powering a massive mining vehicle, generates an impressive 1,650 horsepower. The 1929 Sulzer engine is worth listening to for its unique sound. Here's another demonstration of the Ash 62 aircraft engine. Notably, these engines were still in production in Poland as recently as 2017. Witness one of the Kempton great engines in operation, its distinctive sound signature derived from steam power. This massive engine, comparable in size to those that powered the Titanic, generates 1,800 horsepower. The Bristol Hercules, originally engineered for aviation applications, stands out for its remarkable production run, exceeding 57,000 units, and its innovative sleeve valve design, which delivered quieter operation compared to contemporary engines. The Fairchild Ranger represents another engineering achievement, featuring an inverted radial V12 configuration optimized for aviation, delivering approximately 550 horsepower. CLERGET series encompassed pioneering rotary aircraft engines from the World War I period, engineered by the innovative Pierre Clerget. These engines were manufactured both in France by Clerget Blin and in Great Britain by Gwynne's Limited, powering notable aircraft, including the Sopwith Camel and Vickers Gunbus. The Wright ART-1820 Cyclone 9, an American radial engine created by Curtis Wright, achieved widespread adoption in aircraft from the 1930s through 1950s. International production included licensed manufacturing in France as the Hispano-Suiza 9 Vol, or Hispano-Wright 9 Voy, and Soviet production as the SCHWEZOW M25. The ART-1820 Cyclone 9 evolved from the Wright P2 engine of 1925, incorporating increased displacement and numerous technological advancements. Production initiated in 1931 and continued extensively through the 1950s. The Turbine Engine Division in Stratford, Connecticut, developed this engine under the leadership of Anselm Franz, who previously served as chief designer of the Junkers Jumo 004 during World War II. A larger variant, sharing similar design principles, evolved into the Lycoming T-55, now manufactured by Honeywell Aerospace. Currently, the T-53 model's production continues under Ozark Aeroworks, LLC. The Lycoming R680 stands as Lycoming's inaugural aircraft engine, featuring a 9-cylinder air-cooled radial design. The engine was developed in two primary variants, the E and B series, which shared fundamental characteristics. The B4E variant offered a specialized trainer configuration, incorporating a front exhaust collector ring designed for operation without cylinder air baffles. The R680 achieved its approved type certificate number 42 on February 4, 1930. The AJ-26 rocket engine represents an evolution of the Soviet NK-33 engine, initially conceived for the USSR's Luna program. Orbital Sciences Corporation later modified it for implementation in the Taurus II launch vehicle. The Pratt & Whitney R985 Wasp Jr. represents a family of 9-cylinder, air-cooled, radial aircraft engines manufactured by the Pratt & Whitney Aircraft Company from the 1930s through the 1950s. These robust engines featured a displacement of 16 liters, with early variants generating 300 horsepower, while the most common models delivered 450 horsepower. Rolls-Royce originated from Henry Royce's engineering enterprise, established in 1884, which initially focused on dynamo and electric crane manufacturing. The partnership with Charles Rolls formed in 1904, driven by Rolls' interest in marketing Royce's automotive developments. The formal incorporation of Rolls-Royce Limited occurred in 1906. In 1971, financial difficulties led Rolls-Royce Limited to enter voluntary liquidation, a status that continues to the present day.